But crime isn't the only problem plaguing urban streets. In many cities, slums are reaching epidemic proportions. Multiple families crammed into one small room. Human waste pours into the streets, alleys, and open courtyards.
In many cities, slums reach an epidemic proportions. Multiple families were crammed into a small room. Human waste was poured into the streets.
Jacob Riis, Danish immigrant, crime reporter, photographer. He gets leads for stories from Chief Inspector Burns. Now, he's about to expose the hell of tenements. Jacob Riis knows what it's like to be poor. 15 years ago, he lost his job in a stock market crash. This is one of the first ever photographs of slum life.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Jacob A. Riis, and this is how the other half live.
It shocks millions. Magazines refuse to print his work, so Riis puts on his own magic lantern shows. His mission? To show the nation's wealthy something they've never seen before. Filth and desperation on their doorstep.
Jacob Riis, a reformer who used poses and a photograph for showing working condition of the immigrants. He wrote the book How the Other Half Lives. By this work, he wanted to improve the working condition of the immigrants.
Riis publishes his pictures in a book called How the Other Half Lives. It will sell more than 28 million copies. Within two decades, the worst of New York slums are torn down. Tenements sell at auction for as little as a dollar. Riis's campaigning forces all New York schools to build playgrounds and landlords to install toilets inside apartments, not outside. It is the first step in tackling the slums.